The hand therapy clinic here at St. Joseph's Healthcare sees 100 or more patients per day. The problem and the challenge is that when therapists are treating patients by making splints for them, it can be a time-consuming process. And sometimes these splints, they don't always work out for patients because the materials that are used are, they can be very uncomfortable, very hot, very sweaty, and therapists report that patients have trouble complying with the splints, which means they have trouble wearing them. And a splint only works for treating a patient if they can actually wear it for a long period of time. So we've developed a process by which we can use 3D printing technologies to make splints in a different way, which takes the load off of therapists, but also creates a better splint for patients. So the process begins with this 3D scanner. What we do is we ask the patient to place their arm inside the scanner like this, and the 42 cameras around the scanner take instant snapshots of the patient's arm. And from that, we use a process called photogrammetry, which stitches together all those 42 images into a three-dimensional model of the patient's arm. And then we take that 3D model into our software, and from that, we can create a splint, which would look something like this, as an example. And then from here, we would send that model to a 3D printer, which would produce this, and then a therapist would place a fastener on it so that the patient can wear it comfortably. This initiative opens up new possibilities in terms of bringing healthcare closer to home. When patients need a new replacement splint, they don't have to come to the hospital, which sometimes requires hours of driving. We can simply 3D print a new one from their file and mail it to their home. This is also part of our long-term vision of creating these softwares and these technologies in order to ultimately bring healthcare closer to home for patients. The system that we've developed here has come together as a team effort, which has included engineers, software technicians, hand therapists, and surgeons here at St. Joseph's Healthcare. Well, this has only been made possible by the community and their support for research projects like these. I really want to thank the donors for stepping up and contributing to our research and to the work that's being done here at St. Joseph's Healthcare. I'm extra proud that together we will be the first in Canada to offer this.